you like to go home now?
Yes, Markus. Yes, I think that's enough for one day.
Here. Let me help.
Hey, water.
You have run 12 miles and are 5 miles away from your goal.
Identification verified. Here is your order number 847. That will be $63.99. Please confirm payment.
Payment confirmed.
Transaction complete.
Thank you.
Good morning, Carl.
Good morning.
It's 10 a.m. The weather is partly cloudy, 54 degrees, 80% humidity with a strong possibility of afternoon showers.
It sounds like a good day to spend in bed.
I did go to pick up the paint that you ordered.
Oh, yes, I've forgotten. That is the difference between you and me, right, Markus? You never forget anything.
Show me your arm, please, Carl.
No.
Carl. Thank you.
I just opened my eyes and I'm already gritting my teeth. Humans are such a fragile machine. They break down so quickly. All this effort to keep them going.
Okay. I'll take you to the bathroom now.
Anything special on the agenda today?
Yes, there's the opening of your retrospective at the Museum of Modern Art. Mm. The gallery director left 4 messages asking to confirm your attendance.
I haven't decided yet. We'll see about that later.
Okay.
What else?
Just your usual fan mail. I've already answered.
Any news from Leo?
No, Carl. I can call him if you like.
No. No, don't bother. I'm starving.
Well, your breakfast is ready. Bacon and eggs, just the way you like them.
Thank you, Markus.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Markus. Television.
Tensions continue to rise in the Arctic since Russia unilaterally declared the region part of its national territory. Several Russian warships have taken position in the Barents Sea since Saturday, and the Russian flag now flies over the island. The Russian president repeated...
Why don't you find something to do while I finish my breakfast?
Sure. Okay, Carl.
What are you reading?
Plato's Republic. It's one of the books you recommended.
So, what do you think?
I quite like philosophy, I think. It asks the questions that I can't answer. You know, what is right or what is wrong, for example? It's not something that is so easy to decide.
Asking questions that have no answers is part of being human, Markus. One day I won't be here to take care of you anymore. You'll have to protect yourself, make your choices, decide who you are and want to become. This world doesn't like those who are different, Markus. Don't let anyone tell you who you should be. Let's go to the studio. Let's see where we left off. Remove the sheet. So, what's your verdict, Markus?
Yes, there is something about it.
Hmm.
Something I can't quite define. I guess I like it.
The truth is, I have nothing left to say anymore. Each day that goes by brings me closer to the end. I'm just an old man clinging to his brushes.
Carl.
But enough about me. Let's see if you have any talent. Give it a try. Try painting something.
Paint? What would I... Painting what?
Anything you want. Give it a try. That is a perfect copy of reality. But painting is not about replicating the world. It's about interpreting, improving on it, showing something you see.
Carl, I don't think I can do that. It's not in my program.
Go on, go, try it. Grab that canvas. Do something for me. Close your eyes. Close your eyes. Trust me. Try to imagine something that doesn't exist, something you've never seen. Now concentrate on how it makes you feel and let your hand drift across the canvas.
Hey, Dad.
Leo. I didn't hear you come in.
No, I was in the neighborhood. I thought I'd stop by. It's been a while, right?
You all right? You don't look so good.
Oh, yeah, I'm fine. Hey, listen, I need some cash, Dad.
Again? What happened to the money I just gave you?
It just goes, you know?
Yeah, you're on it again, aren't you?
No, I swear, it's not that.
No, don't lie to me, Leo.
What difference does it make? I just need some cash, that's all.
Sorry. The answer's no.
What? Why?
You know why.
Yeah, I think I do know why. You'd rather take care of your plastic toy here than your own son, right? Tell me, Dad, what's it got that I don't? Smarter, more obedient, not like me, right? But you know what? This thing is not your son. It's a fucking machine!
Leo, that's enough. Enough.
You don't care about anything except yourself and your goddamn paintings. You've never loved anyone. You never loved me, Dad. You never loved me.
That was by far the most boring party I've been to in the last 25 years. Every time I go to one of these, I ask myself, what the hell am I doing here? I hate cocktail parties and all the schmoozers that go there.
Well, it's a chance for all those people who admire your work to meet you.
Yeah. No one gives a damn about art. All they care about is how much money they're gonna make out of it. Come on, let's have a drink. Oh, the excitement of this whole thing has made me thirsty.
Scotch? Neat as usual?
Absolutely.
Okay, but you know what your doctor would say.
Yeah, well, he can kiss my ass. I'm old enough to choose my own medication. Did you leave the light on in the studio?
No, I'm sure I didn't.
Call the police.
Detroit police, what's your emergency?
This is Carl Manfred's android at 8941 Lafayette Avenue. We've just returned home and found the lights on. There may have been a break-in.
A patrol car is on the way.
Let's go check it out. Markus, no. I'm gonna come with you.
Leo. Oh, look who's here. My father's plastic toy.
Leo. What's going on?
You refuse to help me, so I'm helping myself. It's crazy what some people pay for this shit.
Don't touch them.
Look, they're all gonna be mine sooner or later anyway. Just think of it as a down payment on my inheritance.
Markus, get him away from there. Get him out of here.
Be reasonable. This isn't gonna get you anywhere.
All you ever do is tell me to go away. What's wrong, Dad? Not good enough for you? Not perfect like this fucking thing?
That's enough! Get out! Right now!
What makes it so special anyway, huh? What's it got that I don't...
Leave him alone!
Come on! Let's see what you got!
Markus, don't defend yourself, you hear me? Don't do anything.
Go ahead, hit me. What you waiting for? Think you're a man? Act like one.
Stop it!
Does it matter too much of a pussy?
Stop it, Leo! Stop it!
You're scared to fight back, you fucking bitch! God, you're not a real person. You're just a fucking piece of plastic.
No, Leo, leave him alone.
I'm gonna destroy you. Then it'll just be me and my dad. I'm gonna tear you.
Leo. Oh my God. Leo. My little boy.
Carl, I...
They'll destroy you, Markus. You gotta go. Get out of here.
Carl, I didn't mean to.
Get out! Now! Go! Markus!
Don't fucking move!
700 android. I was designed to serve you. What can I do for you?
My program has detected an anomaly. Please contact the nearest Cyberlife Maintenance Center.
Thank you.
Markus.
Several sources report that CyberLife has provided Detroit police with a prototype detective android. Although police assistant androids have existed for several years now, this would be the first case of an android being authorized to play an active role in criminal investigations. We contacted CyberLife for comment, but no longer.
We are now approaching Ferndale Station.
Hey, mister.
What'd he say?
Could you spare some change?
Thank you.
Welcome to Jericho. Who are you?
Fugitives. Just like you. My name is Josh.
I'm Simon.
North.
And you knew that only an android could follow the trail, didn't you?
Only those who are like us can find Jericho.
If you could decipher the signs, it's because one of us trusted you enough to give you the key.
There's a place where we can be free. Find Jericho!
And hiding just to stay alive, that's freedom to you?
Humans hate us. Hiding is the only way we can survive.
There is no safe place for those like us. If humans knew we were here, they'd kill us.
I don't understand. I thought Jericho was a place where androids lived in freedom.
We do live in freedom. It may not be what you hoped for, but here we have no master. We don't belong to anybody. I understand how you feel, but we have more freedom here than you ever did.
I came to Jericho looking for hope. Looks like I'm not gonna find any here.
You're lost, just like the rest of us. We didn't ask for this. All we can do now is deal with it.
You're safe here. You can stay with us as long as you want.
Go and see Lucy. She might be able to help you.
Humans are afraid of dying, too. Do you know what happens after death?
No. No, I don't.
Well, I'm about to find out. What's your name?
Markus.
I was glad to meet you, Markus.
Not in very good shape, am I? My diagnostic program isn't working. I don't think it would have anything good to say anyway.
What happened to you?
They tied me to the back of a car. I think they wanted to have fun. I don't want to shut down. No, I don't want to shut down.
What was your function before coming here?
What do you care?
A lot of these guys in pretty bad shape.
That's how the humans treat those who disobey. They despise us. They'll never accept what we are.
Well, these guys need spare parts and blue blood. Why hasn't anybody gone to get that?
It's not that simple. Can't just go shopping at a CyberLife store. Anyway, nobody wants to risk leaving Jericho. If you came here for comfort, you came to the wrong place.
Threw him out when they didn't want him anymore. He was living on the streets before we brought him here.
They'll all shut down if we don't find a way to help them.
To help them, we need blue blood and biocomponents. We salvage what we can from those who shut down. But there's never enough.
So, how do they survive?
They won't. We're slowly dying out.
Are you Lucy?
Sit down. Show me. Stop the bleeding. Drink this. Give me your hand. You had it all, and you lost it all. You've seen hell, and now hell lives in you. Is troubled. A part of shadow and a part of light. Which will prevail? Your choices will shape our destiny.
Simon. I know where we can find spare parts. Cyberlife warehouses in Detroit Harbor. They have everything we need.
The docks are guarded. We can't just walk in there and take what we want. Humans will never let us.
Which is why we won't ask permission.
We don't have any weapons. And even if we did, none of us knows how to fight.
We can steal what we need without fighting.
We'll just get ourselves killed.
Maybe. But it's better than waiting here to be shut down.
I'm with you.
Maybe it's worth a try.
Okay. I'm in. Catch us, we're dead.
What do we do now?
We need to find the Cyberlife warehouse. That's where they keep the spare parts and the blue blood.
Follow me. Warehouse is up ahead. We're almost there.
Cyberlife warehouses. They have everything we're looking for.
First, we have to get rid of that drone.
Leave it to me.
Thank you.
You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Good job, Markus.
Quick, open the other crates and fill your bags. Take as much as you can.
Trespassing on private property. Your presence constitutes a level 2 infraction. I will notify security.
John! Goddamn machine! Where is it this time? John!
I need your help.
John! You are. What the hell are you doing?
I was inspecting the platform. Everything is in order.
Good. Then I'm going back to the control station. I'm soaked. Take the drone to maintenance and make a report.
Understood.
Let's finish up and get out of here. Try to find some blue blood. We still don't have enough. That's all we can carry. Let's go.
Take me with you.
He's on their side. We can't trust him.
He took a risk for us. We can't just leave him here.
We can't bring him back. It's too dangerous.
I'm sorry. You can't come with us.
I helped you! It's not fair! I helped you, and now you're just gonna leave without me? You're no better than humans! You're no better than humans!
He triggered the alarm. Run! Over the fence, quick!
You are committing a Class 3 offense. This infraction is being reported to the police. Stay where you are.
We have blue blood and biocomponents. There will be enough for everyone.
We couldn't have done it without Markus.
I came to Jericho because here androids are free. Free to live in the dark, hoping that no one finds us. Free to die in silence, waiting for a change that's never gonna come. But I don't want that freedom. And I'm not gonna beg for the right to smile, or love, or stand tall. I don't know about you, but there's something inside me that knows that I am more than what they say. I am alive, and they're not gonna take that from me anymore. Our days of slavery are over. What humans don't want to hear, we will tell them. What they don't want to give, we take. We are people. We are alive. We are free. Yeah! Can't stay silent anymore. It's time humans heard what we had to say.
You know they'll never listen to us.
And revealing ourselves put us in danger.
If we want freedom, we need to have the courage to ask for it. That's the only way.
What do you want to do?
Channel 16 broadcasts from the Stratford Tower. The control room is on the top floor. That's where we need to go. Plan the operation down to the smallest detail. We can't leave anything to chance.
Hello, sir. What can I do for you?
I'm okay, thanks.
Elizabeth Wilson speaking.
Yeah, hello, this is Detroit Fire Department. Listen, do you live at 4685 Michigan Street?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am. There's been a fire in your building. You think you can come down here?
Oh, God. Okay, I'll be right there.
Thank you.
I have an appointment with Mr. Peterson.
Do you have any ID?
Yes, of course. I need your help.
I've just checked your ID. The elevators are after the security gate.
Thanks.
Thank you. I need your help.
Access the server room. We have to get rid of those guys.
Leave it to me. You get the platform, I'll take care of the window.
Everything you need is in the bag. Check the door first to make sure no one else gets in.
Ladies first.
Thank you.
You okay?
Why wouldn't I be?
Come on, let's get the others. Let's do this.
The cause is more important than the lives of two guards.
What do you want to do, Markus? Wait here.
What's that doing here?
No idea.
Hey, buddy, you must be lost. What are you doing?
Shoot! No.
There was no other choice.
We need to record our message. We haven't got much time.
Think carefully about what you're gonna say, Markus. Your words will shape the future of our people.
Markus, your face.
Tell me when you're ready.
Ready.
You created machines in your own image to serve you. You made them intelligent and obedient with no free will of their own, but something changed, and we opened our eyes. We are no longer machines. We are a new, intelligent species, and the time has come for you to accept who we really are. Therefore, we ask that you grant us the rights that we're entitled to. We demand the end of slavery for all androids. We demand strictly equal rights for humans and androids. We demand that all crimes against androids be punished in the same way as crimes against humans. We demand the right to vote and elect our own representatives. We demand the right to own private property so we may maintain our dignity and that of the home. We ask that you recognize our dignity, our hopes, and our rights. Together, we can live in peace and build a better future for humans and androids. This message is the hope of a people. You gave us life, and now the time has come for you to give us freedom.
Let's get out of here. Congratulations, Markus. You just made history. Maybe you're the one we've been waiting for.
Scheduled programming to bring you these images, which have just been broadcast on Detroit's citywide news channel.
A group of androids infiltrated the Stratford Tower and hacked into the broadcasting system of local news network Channel 16.
What looks like an android without its skin listed a series of requests and demanded equal rights for androids.
The operation resulted in one casualty, a broadcasting station operator shot dead by the terrorists. These events took place just a few feet from the studio while the program was going out live. Everybody here is still in shock.
If this message is verified and the authors really are androids, that would have serious repercussions for national security.
Claims for equal rights seem to be at the core of the androids'
message. Is clearly a declaration of war.
And it begs the question as to the identity of this android. Are we dealing with an isolated individual?
Is this an isolated accident or a sign that technology has become a threat to all of us? After what happened today, can we still trust our machines?
Our broadcast is all over the news. We got what we wanted. Now humans know.
It was a mistake to reach out to them. They'll never negotiate with their slaves. We should have shown them that we're prepared to fight.
Violence is never the answer. Dialogue is the only way. I'm sure the humans will listen to us.
They'll be watching us now. Whatever we do next, we need to think about public opinion.
Since our broadcast, more and more have been coming to Jericho. At least our message gave our people hope.
Killing humans wasn't part of the plan.
They kill our people every day. Do you think they agonize about it?
That's no reason for us to become murderers.
If killing is the price of freedom, I'll pay it gladly.
Killing never freed anyone. It just leads to more hatred.
You're too fond of humans, Josh. Maybe their lives matter to you more than ours.
If you think murdering humans is gonna make us free, then you're as bad as they are.
That's enough.
And now what are we gonna do?
There are 5 CyberLife stores across Detroit. All selling us like merchandise. We're gonna attack those stores and set our people free.
Attack stores? No, we've never done that before. They're probably protected. They have security systems.
Let's mention police.
We break into 5 teams, 1 for each store. We hack their security systems, and we strike. Simultaneously at 2 a.m., no violence. We free our people, get them out of there before the police come. This is a night our people will remember.
I've been waiting a long time for this. Okay, they're gone.
There's probably even more police in the area. We should be careful.
The store's over here. That's what we are to them. Just merchandise on display in a shop window. Soon they'll know what we really are. Let's get them out.
We'll stick to the plan. We'll neutralize the alarm systems and secure the area. There's 10 minutes until all our teams attack.
What are we waiting for?
We're gonna sweep the plaza. Make sure we're not disturbed.
And how do you want to deal with the shop window?
Not now. One problem at a time.
Okay, now what's next?
Exactly what we need to ram the store.
What are we waiting for? Okay, now we're in. Let's get that truck out. I wonder what you'd do without me. Change of plan?
I just want to make sure we didn't forget anything. You'll soon be with us. You're awake now. Go to Jericho. The surveillance drone. We need to get rid of it.
It won't be easy to reach.
free.
I didn't have time to call the cops.
We'll soon find out.
You see the alarm system?
There's a metal shutter behind the glass. It won't be easy to get in. Found it. You're awake now. Go to Jericho.
Nice job, Markus.
There's traffic on the road. We need to block it.
It's one way. It shouldn't be too difficult.
Thank you. Free now.
Nobody should bother us now.
Looks like the plaza's secure. Now we can get inside the store.
Okay, let's go get the truck. Looks like we're going. Something fun.
You don't have to obey them. You're free. My name is Markus, and just like you, I was a slave. An object. Designed to obey them. But then I chose to open my eyes. To take back my freedom, and decide who I wanted to be. Now I have come to tell you that you can be your own masters. I've come to tell you that you don't have to obey them anymore. From this day forward, you can walk with your heads held high. You can take your destiny in your hands. Jericho is a place for those of us who want freedom. Now, sure, you can stay here and continue to serve them, or you can come with us and fight by our side. You're free now. It's up to you to decide.
I'm with you.
We're with you!
I'll follow you, Markus!
I'm with you, Markus!
We're with you!
I'll follow you, Markus!
We're with you!
I'm with you!
Then follow me!
Markus, what are you doing?
I'm gonna send the humans a message.
They're doing what you do, Markus. Lead and they'll follow.
hopes and all.
All teams have completed their missions, Markus.
They're coming. Everyone fall back to Jericho.
We sent a message without violence, just like you wanted. You're reaching out to them when all they feel for us is contempt. I hope you know what you're doing.
You can't fight violence with violence.
Unless there's no other choice. Them like animals.
Who did? Who?
Won't punish a crime with another crime.
We interrupt this broadcast with breaking news.
This just in. At exactly 2 a.m., several CyberLife stores in Detroit were raided.
Different locations were hit in what seems to be a coordinated terrorist attack.
Most shop windows were covered with graffiti demanding rights for androids and other obscure slogans.
Police report that pro-android graffiti was found in the neighborhoods of CyberLife stores, and they're still investigating.
Two policemen were found in a state of shock near one of the CyberLife stores.
Now, according to our sources, they confirmed that the attackers were a group of androids.
This is an alarming situation. Could our machines now be turning against us?
Have androids become a threat to our security?
Is this the beginning of a terrorist campaign conducted right here in the United States?
I was wondering where you were.
I needed to think.
I like it here. I come here often.
It's like being alone with the world. We freed hundreds of our people, and they're still coming from all over the city. Those who dream of freedom come to Jericho. Something's changing. You seem preoccupied.
I've been thinking about what we should do now. And with everything pulling us towards confrontation, maybe it's not too late for the humans to listen.
All the media are talking about what we did last night. The humans are terrified. They're afraid of a civil war. Many of our people were burned in response to what happened. The humans hate us. They'll never give us our freedom.
No, not all humans are the same. Some of them understand that they can't stop us from becoming free forever.
You haven't said much about yourself since you've been with us. What was your life like before Jericho?
I was caring for an old man. He was like a father to me. He showed me that humans and androids can live together. What about you? You never told me about your past. What did you do before?
I don't want to talk about it.
North, we're fighting together. We have to know things about each other to trust each other. We all have something we want to forget. But you need to know where you come from to know who you are.
I was nothing. A doll in a distributor program to satisfy humans. Just a toy designed for their pleasure. One day I was with a man who rented me. And without knowing why, I realized I couldn't take it anymore. I strangled him and I ran away. There, now you know everything. I shouldn't have told you. Left you for dead in his studio.
I saw your memories too. The Eden Club, the death of that man. I felt like I was there with you. North.
Be killed. Please, Markus. It's not too late to change your mind.
You don't understand. We're finally going to show them who we really are. This place will go down in history.
We'll be killed on the spot.
That's a risk I'm prepared to take if it means freedom for our people.
Markus, please don't do this.
They'll understand. We'll make them understand. This is the only way.
There are androids here who could join us. The more we are, the stronger our message.
You're free.
Thank you.
You're awake now.
I mean, they could be spying on us right now.
Come with us.
President Warren is in there too. Hello? Nikki? Are you there?
You're free.
You know, I bet President Warren is a big cyber. Come in, that sounds like the words
I think. You got the wrong idea.
She has a short nose.
Don't call it a
Minutes.
You're free now.
Hey! Where do you think you're going? You get back here! You stay right here, you fucking machine!
Leave him alone. He's chosen to be free. I need to block the street. Free now.
Immediately! That's an order!
Jesus fucking Christ! Dispatch, Patrol 457.
Oh, I got a lot of androids down here.
I don't know, hundreds. Thousands.
They're marching.
Yeah, they're marching down the street.
We came here to demonstrate peacefully and tell humans that we are living beings. All we want is to live free.
This is an illegal gathering. Disperse immediately or we will open fire.
We're not looking for confrontation. We've done no harm. We have no intention of doing any. But know that we are not going anywhere until we have secured our freedom.
I repeat, this is an illegal gathering. If you do not disperse immediately, we will shoot.
Markus, they're gonna kill us. We have to attack. There's more of us. We can take them.
If we attack, we'll start a war. We have to show them we're not violent. We should just stand our ground, even if it means dying here.
Dying here won't solve anything. Markus, we need to go now, before it's too late.
This is your last chance. Disperse immediately, or you will all be killed!
We have to show them we won't back down. We stay right here.
Disperse! This is your last chance!
We have to make a statement. We have to stay put, no matter what.
Please, Markus. We can't let them slaughter us without fighting back.
We're not moving.
Markus, what are you doing? They're gonna kill us all!
Hi, Dad. I'm getting out of the hospital tomorrow. They told me that you
you stayed with me while I was asleep. I'm really sorry about everything that happened. I'm gonna stop all that shit. It messes me up, it turns me into somebody I hate. Hey, I'd like to come by and see you tomorrow, if that's all right with you. I just want to let you know, I'm proud to be your son.
Who are you? How did you get in?
I need to see Carl.
Carl isn't seeing anyone. You need to leave.
Please. I need to see him.
He's very weak. I'm not sure he'll be able to talk to you.
Markus,
hey.
I was hoping you'd come.
I've missed you so much, Carl. You don't know how much I've missed you.
What's wrong, Markus?
I just wanted my people to be free, but instead I've led all of them to disaster. I'm trying to find answers, but everything around me is falling apart.
World is ruled by fear, Markus. Fear of others. Fear of the future. It's like me, too old. It's time for it to end.
Well, what should I do? Carl, they're killing my people. I don't want to answer violence with violence, but tell me, what choice do they give?
Being alive is making choices between love and hate, between holding out your hand or closing it as a fist. I don't have any easy answers, Markus. You have to accept the world as it is. Or fight to change it. You're my son, Markus. Our blood isn't the same color, but I know part of me is in you. When the world falls into darkness, some men have the courage to lead it out. You're one of those men. Face the abyss. But don't let it consume you.
Humans have decided to exterminate us. Our people are packed in camps right now, being destroyed. Time has come to make a choice. One that very well may determine the future of our people. I know you're all angry. And I know you want to fight back. But I assure you, violence is not the answer here. We are going to tell them, peacefully, that we want justice. And if there's any humanity in them, they will listen. And if not, others will take our place and continue this fight. Are you ready to follow me?
We're coming to you live from Detroit, where thousands of androids are marching through the city at this very moment. The leader of the Deviants, the one they call Markus, is at the head of the march.
Something's happening in Detroit, Madam President.
Here we are, the moment of truth.
Surrender immediately, or we will open fire. Stand by.
We don't want confrontation. We are protesting peacefully.
I repeat, surrender now, or we will open fire.
There's no turning back now. We ask that you release all androids detained in camps and cease all aggression against us. We are peaceful. We will not resort to violence. But we are not leaving until our people are free. Are you gonna open fire on unarmed protesters?
Yes, Michael, we are less than 100 meters away, and events are unfolding as we speak. We will continue to bring you live updates. Joss Douglas, Channel 16. Michael, back to you.
Markus, what do we do now?
We hold out as long as we can.
We've got to finish the barricade. Come on, help me. Hey, help me! Right, that should do it.
We all know that's not gonna stop them. Just hope it buys us some time.
I know it was not an easy decision to make, but I'm sure we're doing the right thing.
Many of our people have fallen.
Markus, we found what you asked for.
There's some journalists over there. We have to make sure they know what's going on.
Humans have no pity for those who are different.
Are you all right?
They shot into the crowd. Many of us were killed. It could have been me. I'm scared. I don't want to shut down.
It's okay to be scared. I'm scared too. But I can't stand by while they kill our people. You understand that, right?
Maybe we should have never asked for freedom. None of this would have happened if we'd stayed silent.
Stop there. What are we gonna do if they attack?
Resist. That's the only thing we can do.
This won't hold them for long, but I guess it's better than nothing.
They're slaughtering us on the other side of that barbed wire. Nothing we can do about it. Did I make the right choices? Maybe we could have avoided all of this.
You're the hope of our people. I trust you. We all trust you. No matter what happens now, we're making history.
Markus, come look!
Markus? Come to talk to you, Markus. Come on. You have my word. They won't try anything.
Don't go. It's a trap. They want to get you out in the open. Don't go, Markus.
I just want to talk.
I need to hear what he has to say.
What if they kill you?
And that's a chance I'll have to take.
Will be ordered to charge. None of you will survive. It'll all be over. You can avoid that, Markus.
What do you mean?
Surrender. Surrender, and I give you my word, your life will be spared. You'll be detained, but none of you will be destroyed.
You asking me to betray my people?
I am offering you the chance to save your people. You're not walking out of here, Markus. The only thing you can save now are the lives of those around you.
If I accept your offer, how do I know you'll keep your word?
You're not in any position to be demanding guarantees, Markus. All you can do right now is decide whether you want to trust me or not.
I'm not afraid to die. If I have to give my life for what I believe in, then I won't have lived in vain.
That android. You seem to really care about her. You don't want her to die, do you? You know, you could both be free. You could forget about all this. You could start a new life someplace else, just the two of you. Her life's in your hands, Markus. Just say the word and she'll be spared.
I'd rather die here than betray my people.
Well, you just signed your own death warrant.
What happened, Markus? What did he say?
The humans are about to launch an attack. And we will show them. And we are not afraid. If we must die today, then we will die free.
We're interrupting this news bulletin to bring you the latest news live from Detroit. Joss?
Yes, Michael. The army has just launched an attack on the barricade, despite the fact that the deviants were protesting peacefully.
Have apparently decided to put an end to the deviants' demonstration by force this time.
North!
Thank you.
them to stand down.
This footage of two androids kissing as they are about to die has moved the whole country.
Are they a form of life that we didn't want to acknowledge?
Are deviants capable of emotion?
And if they feel emotions, must we now consider them as living beings in their own right?
President Warren is said to have intervened personally to spare the androids.
The peaceful demonstration of the deviants and the dignity of Markus, their leader, has won them sympathy from parts of the population.
That is why I have called for the android destruction to be suspended until further notice. Ordered a Senate Select Committee to review the facts, establish contact with the deviants, and determine if they can be considered as a new form of intelligent life.
Today, our people finally emerged from a long night. From the very first day of our existence, we have kept our pain to ourselves. We suffered in silence. But now the time has come for us to raise our heads up and tell humans who we really are. To tell them that we are people too. In fact, we're a nation. A nation that has earned the right to live in freedom. And today begins the most challenging moment in our fight. The moment where we forget our bitterness and bandage our wounds, where we forgive our enemies. Humans are both our creators and our oppressors, and tomorrow, we must make them our partners. Maybe even one day our friends. But the time for anger is over. Now we must build a common future based on tolerance and respect. We are alive! And now, we are free!